In this video, we're going to discuss the difference between fixed and variable manufacturing overhead costs. But first, a little review. Manufacturing overhead consists of all costs of manufacturing except for the cost of direct materials and direct labor. And that's because direct materials and direct labor are directly traceable to the product being manufactured. Manufacturing overhead, on the other hand, is not directly traceable to the product being manufactured, and that's why we sometimes call manufacturing overhead the indirect manufacturing cost. People will sometimes also refer to manufacturing overhead as factory overhead or factory burden, and that's because manufacturing takes place in a factory. Now, we can break manufacturing overhead into two components. There's a fixed component of manufacturing overhead, and then there is a variable component of manufacturing overhead. So let's look at an example. Let's say that you want to start manufacturing a product, a food product, that is going to be a healthy alternative to pizza and ice cream. So you start manufacturing donuts. Okay, you've got a donut factory here. You're making these beautiful donuts to help people lose weight. Now, what would be included in the fixed component of manufacturing overhead? Well, for example, real estate taxes that you incur for that factory. Okay, any real estate taxes aren't going to change. They're not going to get higher or lower based on how many donuts that you make, right? So the real estate taxes are going to be a fixed cost. Now, any insurance that you get for the factory, right? So you get some insurance in case the factory were to burn down. The cost of the insurance, like the real estate taxes, that's not going to change whether you make 1,000 donuts, whether you make 1,100 donuts, 1,200 donuts, okay? It's not going to change. Now, depreciation, okay? When we think about depreciation expense, whether it be depreciation expense for the factory itself or depreciation expense for the manufacturing equipment that is inside the factory, okay? The machines that you're using to produce those donuts. Generally, that is going to be part of fixed manufacturing overhead because the depreciation is not going to change based on how many donuts you make. However, there is an exception. If you were to use the units of production method for depreciation, which some companies use, if you use that, in that case, depreciation would be linked to the level of output. And in that scenario, then depreciation would be a variable component of manufacturing overhead. But generally speaking, unless we have units of production method, depreciation, which is a large part of manufacturing overhead usually, it's part of the fixed component of manufacturing overhead. Now, in terms of variable manufacturing overhead, what are the things we have there? Indirect materials. So if you were manufacturing, let's say something, the tables or something made out of wood, and you had some glue that you occasionally use glue for the table, and it's such a trivial amount of glue that you use, you don't consider it as a direct material. So that would be an example of indirect material. Indirect labor would be an example. Let's say you have a janitor who is cleaning the factory floor, or you have a production supervisor. Okay, so it's not direct labor. They're not actually working on the product itself. Okay, so indirect labor, indirect materials. We would expect that we would use more indirect materials and more indirect labor as production increases. Now, utilities, particularly when we come to energy costs, we would also expect that to increase as production increases. Because in a factory, we're going to use a lot of energy, and the more we're ramping up production, the more energy we're going to consume. So all these costs here, we might expect to vary. Okay, so they're part of manufacturing overhead, but we expect them to vary with the production level, whereas real estate taxes or insurance for the factory, we don't expect that to change based on how many units we produce. Now, note that, as I said earlier, manufacturing overhead is not directly traceable to the product. These are indirect manufacturing overhead costs, right? These are indirect costs of manufacturing, so we need to allocate manufacturing overhead. We can't directly trace it, so we need to allocate it. Now, fixed manufacturing overhead and variable manufacturing overhead, you can allocate them using the exact same cost drivers. Let's say, for example, machine hours was the cost driver that you were using, or you could use different cost drivers, one cost driver for fixed manufacturing overhead and a different cost driver for variable manufacturing overhead.